afternoon. My name is Mike Poirier. I'm the Director of Business Development. Today I'll be assisted by Jonathan Levesque, who is our Technical Director on this webinar. And we have two guests, Jason Tirado and Ronnie Forgione. Jason is the President of Lightware. Lightware is a company that specializes in high-end, multi-frame rate, multi-resolution, HDMI, HD-based devices, namely very good matrices that Solotech has used in large installs. And with the technology that they've developed over the years, they've come up with some really nifty collaboration products that they're going to talk to us about today. So if you're not familiar with the format, it's a short intro like I'm doing right now, followed by our presenters talking about their product. And then at the end, we have a short Q&A. So you're more than welcome to write your questions in the Q&A section of the webinar. And don't worry, if we don't get to your question today, we will definitely have somebody get back to you with a proper answer on whatever question you may have. Without further ado, let me introduce Jason Tirado, President of Lightware, who's going to talk to us about their new products focused on collaboration in an era of COVID-19, of course. Jason?
Thank you, Michel. Good to see you again. And I also want to just complete that introduction for Ronnie Forgione. Ronnie's going to follow up after I'm done, and he's the Territory Sales Manager for Canada. So if anybody out there wants to talk about sales in Canada, please, Ronnie's your guy. And I will say, you know, Solotech has been one of the top integrators for Lightware for many, many years. And due to this close relationship, we decided to try to include some of our new technologies together and talk about it together in this age, as Michel said, of COVID-19. I think one of the things that we've been talking about just between us is how important remote management, remote monitoring, and the ability to manage and monitor products when you're not there, because now none of us are there anymore. You know, we're all working from our homes, we're all remote. And so the ability for either us as users or enterprise level people to be able to know what's going on in a given room or a given system, it's extremely important. It's always been important, but it becomes even more so when we're restricted by movement like we are these days. And so I think it goes to one of the strengths of Lightware in terms of our open API. An API is an application programmer's interface. And what that means is it's a set of documented instructions that tell a third party, either a piece of software or a person, exactly what's happening inside of a system. And it's documented all the way down to the very elemental parts, such as whether a signal is actually present or not. I'll give you a particular example. We were talking to a multinational end user that was considering to deploy Lightware in hundreds and hundreds of rooms, I think even thousands at the time. And one of the things that they were very concerned with was they could not afford to, and it wouldn't be practical, to send people around to every single room every day to try to make sure the room is ready or to make sure the room is functional, you know, and ready for the day's events. And so what they were very interested in was being able to remotely know what was the state of the room. Do they have good signal presence? Is the CPU temperature itself running hot? I mean, that's a big indicator if something's about to go wrong, if your CPU temperature is running too hot, just like the engine on your car. You know, you'd really want to know that if you're about to take a long drive, that you've got something you need to go take a look at. And so things like the serial number, the Mac ID, the firmware version, all of those things that are very important when you're managing hundreds, if not thousands of rooms, they're all available to you from the Lightware product using our open API. And it's a very fundamental thing that we've deployed through all of our product lines, and that we're now leaning on more and more heavily in this age when we've got to be a little bit remote like we are today. One of the other things that this particular customer was asking about was, they said, you know, Jason, we understand the computer, right? You know, your computer has a USB camera, you've got a display, you've got a microphone, speakers, Ethernet, USB, power requirements. The computer is a very well-known device. But what the rooms that people are building these days, they've got a lot in common. Because you think about that small room, they've got a USB camera, they've got a monitor or two, they've got USB power, Ethernet requirements. And so to me, it's almost the same thing. It's instead of I'm sitting in front of the computer, I'm actually sitting inside the computer. And if I take that analogy a little bit further, if you had a problem with your computer right now, you wouldn't expect that Microsoft or Apple is going to send somebody into your room to go help you fix the computer. They're going to remote in. And they're going to use the networking technologies that they've developed for many years to be able to tell exactly what's going on with your system and help you remotely get back up and running. And that's the very same thing that's happening with the rooms these days, is we want to be able to give that same level of knowledge, of management, of monitoring, but do it for all the signals in the room. So whether you're using USB cameras, USB microphones, speakers, whether you're bringing in your laptop for presentation, whether you've got audio DSPs, you should know everything that's going on in that room before you get there to be able to help your management and monitoring. And so we set about to create a product line that solves this problem, because you could solve it today, but you'd solve it with about five or six different boxes underneath the table and five or six boxes in the credenza. And that's not a very elegant approach. There's a lot of room for failure. There's a lot of room for mismatch in terms of capability and firmware versions. And so what we've done is we looked at it as if this was about five or six separate layers. So first of all, if I'm in that room and I bring in my laptop and I've just gotten this Zoom invitation, I want to host that meeting on my laptop using the invitation that was sent to me, but I want to use that display in the room and I want to use that camera in the room instead of having everybody huddle around my computer, right? Because that doesn't make any sense. Let's use the assets of the room. And so one of the layers is the video layer, right? So now I'm going to plug in my laptop somehow, either using USB-C or HDMI, and I'm going to send my extended desktop to that display in the room. I actually have a version of our product right here that I can kind of share with you. And in this case, I could say kind of right along the front there, you can see those USB-C inputs and HDMI inputs. And so somebody at the room would be able to plug in there, and then they would be able to go to the outputs and the displays in the room. So that's the video layer. Then there's the audio layer, right? Because you might have some microphones in the room and an external DSP. Well, you can connect that to this product also using Dante. And Dante has become a very, very big technology in the audio world with DSPs and being able to use network audio as well. And so we embedded that capability in this product also. When you come to management and monitoring and you're in an enterprise environment, you've also got to be aware of Ethernet security requirements. And so we've spent a lot of time and energy incorporating a Ethernet layer switch that will accommodate the security requirements of most of these enterprise customers, including 802.1x, radius compliance, SSL, SSH, all those kinds of things. There's also a control layer built in, because I don't know if you got to see it on the other side of this box, but I've got actual control ports on there for RS-232 and GPIO. And so some of the other stuff in the room that you might want to control, maybe you want to turn on monitors remotely, or you want to integrate with the occupancy sensor. So when somebody walks in, there's actually a greeting on the display. And the greeting says, hi, how are you? Let me show you how to use this room. And so there's the control layer, and then finally there's the USB layer, because a lot of devices now are coming out with USB connectivity, USB-C connectivity specifically. And because we have to kind of follow where the computer makers are going with those formats, we as manufacturer, if we're in audio and video, we've got to recognize that USB-C is now a legitimate audio, video, data, and power connector. And we've got to have a solution for that. And so that's something we've really been working on very, very diligently over the last several months. We've got this new product that's coming out later this year. And I hope if any of this means something to you in the environments that you're building and thinking about, that you'll give Solotech a call and find out how they can help you with Lightware.
Thank you, Jason. So effectively, it's a brand new product that you guys came up with based on the technology you've developed over the years. We had a chance to use your API in Vegas with the help of the headquarters in Czechoslovakia, and it worked really, really well. We were quite impressed, actually, that it was able to tunnel through the MGM network without issue, and we passed all the security ratings that they needed to have. So it was quite useful. So I can see the value in a product like that in a teleconferencing or teleworking environment where we need to access a bunch of equipment. So this is very, very interesting. Ronnie, you'll tell us about a real application of the same types of technology. And on to you then.
My apology, I had my mic muted there. thank you, Mike. That's what I was trying to find.
The beauty of live TV.
That's right. Well, I want to talk about, before I jump into the new technology, I want to talk about the differences between the bring your own device, or what Jason was referring to, UC platforms like Zoom we're using today, or Microsoft Teams, and a video conferencing room. you know, UC platforms are really what you have installed on your laptop. We all have installed our laptop or mobile devices, and it's tailored to you. And, you know, we share our documents, we share our desktop, video calls, collaborating or chatting, right? These platforms are basically designed for a personal user experience that is associated to you and your device. And the tools that are offered to you in these environments, you know, when you're working at home, you're able to collaborate and share your desktop. That's not really what is a video conferencing experience, because video conferencing rooms are identities, are really resources within a facility. And it is important for an enterprise or an institution like ours.
He pressed the space bar. So, you know, one of the handles is your space bar and mute your microphone.
There you go. Sorry about that. So if we take one of the leading cancer treatment centers in the United States, like Memorial Sloan Kettering, right? We have they have buildings in Manhattan and throughout the state of New York, and I've already standardized on the Cisco platform. Because they need to stay connected, always connected room to room or OR to OR, or need to send a video feed from building to building, the MSK standardized on the Cisco conferencing solution. So they realized that they could simplify the use of technology with their rooms by putting a Cisco codec in the room and using the Touch 10 interface. Maybe some of you know about that product or not. But that was basically eliminating the need of a separate AV switcher or a third-party control system, or standardizing their experience throughout the institution. But the MSK soon found that there was limitation to the Touch 10 platform that was needed for them. So the director of video services was trying to find ways to add more inputs and outputs to their existing rooms, but still use the Touch 10 UI, since their staff have found that the UI was very user-friendly for their as Jason mentioned earlier, Lightware's friendly open API does exactly that. With Cisco having to open their API, we now have the ability to use that Touch 10 to create, you know, buttons and sliders and text and graphics and widgets within the Touch 10. The Lightware product adds much needed inputs and outputs, matrix switching, like again, Jason presented, USB KVM switching, and even adding AV control to the AV devices like displays, projectors, screens, and environmental control layer for lights and shades and all that. The capability of connecting the visible room is something that can be easily added to the Touch 10 along with Lightware. We have even simplified the way of configuring these systems by offering online configuration tools. The whole thing could be done in 7 easy steps, and also provide you with installation guides, wire drawings, and even configuration file that once it's uploaded to the Lightware device, it actually configures the Touch 10 and creates those pages for you. Systems can even be scalable when you're deploying multiple rooms to buildings or even campuses with this configuration tool. Our event manager tool also provides you a level of automation. It gives you any facility the ability to create customized events so users don't even have to press a button. So by simply putting a motion detector in a room, right? So when someone walks in a room, events will happen. We'll turn on the display, bring down the shades, and presenters are ready to start presenting. But we can even do the reverse. When there's no presence within the room, it will shut off the display, bring up the shades, turn on the lights, right? And that's one feature that the MSK loved, because their rooms were automatically managed, and staff didn't have to walk around after a day and start shutting off rooms or putting rooms to sleep. There's so much more that can be done with the event manager, like creating alerts, managing technology remotely, and even know exactly what is connected to a system. Our Cisco integration is unique and offers some features that no other manufacturers offers today. Cisco Canada, in their Toronto training center, has standardized our solution because they can really show the flexibility and the power of the Touch 10 without offering a third-party control system. So with that being said, I would strongly suggest you contact any member of the Solotech sales team to better understand how we can help you further with your UC rooms and your VC deployments.
Thank you, Ronnie. So one of the questions I have for you is, it sounds like this really reduces the number of equipment required to get an all inclusive controlled system or boardroom where I'll be controlling the shades, as well as the lighting, as well as the TV, and the switching, of course, of different sourcing with, or sources, without really needing an external third-party control system.
So if I take the example of a Cisco, exactly. So if I take the example of a Cisco solution, we can take one of our matrix switches, which is a 4x4, which is another model that we have within our catalog. We have, on this end here, we have our control ports. So we have some IR ports, some RS-232 ports, Ethernet control. On the other side, this is a simple 4x2 with a HDBaseT extender that has additional inputs. And of course, an RS-232 port, our IR port. This, with a Cisco WebEx room kit, you can definitely do a room and don't no need of a third-party control system.
So it integrates to the Cisco WebEx system effectively?
Correct. And how it's done is basically over USB. We actually talk to the Cisco device over USB. So this actually sits behind the network. So there's another layer of security. So, you know, Cisco is proven to be a pure, of course, them being in the network world, are fully secure and can be on a network. We will sit behind them and we still can be managed and know exactly what's going on with your system at any given time.
Very good. Another question would be, how do you guys work when it comes to, of course, in a COVID-19, let's say we want to do an install and we need some of your equipment. Are you having issues with logistics or are we able to deliver equipment without issue in a COVID-19 environment that's become an important factor in delivering equipment?
I'll jump in and take that answer if you don't mind, Michel. Thank you.
Absolutely.
It's a great question, and I know a lot of companies are struggling for components right now, you know, because of the interconnected nature of the way manufacturing works. No matter if you're a manufacturer, every one of us depends upon components from other suppliers. You know, we're all integrators at the end of the day. But our supply chain has not been impacted at all. Our inventory in the United States is healthy. We've got plenty of product around. We haven't had any difficulties fulfilling any orders that we've got. So I'd say if you're interested right now, of course, check with your Solotech team member. But definitely, we've got the stuff and we're ready to ship if you're ready to place an order.
Perfect. We are qualified as an essential service, so we're able to urgently deliver. So that's great. Well, gentlemen, hold on. One question has come up. Is there a requirement for custom programming or is the API fairly easy? Is it a low level or high level API?
I'll jump on that one a little bit. I want to differentiate. The API allows the information to be available to a system, right? You know, maybe your management or monitoring system, you're a platform, and you want to know particular things about what's going on within the Lightware, you would use the API to grab that information. Now, what Ronnie was describing is we've also got a built-in controller, right, inside the box, a logical controller that he was using to describe the event manager capability. And that is a very straightforward, I wouldn't say easy. If you say easy, it always ends up sounding like it's too easy. But I would say that it's very accessible. And within a few minutes, if you understand the if-then conditional logic structure, the way that Boolean programming works, then you're going to feel very comfortable right away and very quickly.
Very good. One of the questions from one of our American colleagues, he's asking who would be his main contact in America, Jason?
You can start off with me. Yeah, I'm sitting at home right now, so it's okay. You can call me or email me.
Your schedule is freed up, right?
I haven't been to the airport in 4 weeks. It feels weird, but yeah, give me a call.
Very good. Well, all I can say is we've done really well today. We're exactly at 20 minutes. Had some great input from external people. Can't thank enough Jason and Ronnie for this great presentation. And remember, this is going on every Wednesday at 2:00. There's a schedule that will be output to show if there are any changes, but generally speaking, on Wednesdays, 2:00, until further notice, we'll be doing this. And we always have some great subjects about how we can help you at Solotech and with great manufacturers like Lightware, products that allow you to work remotely and improve your situation effectively. Thank you very much, and we'll see you in about a week.
Thank you. Thank you.
check this out.